Florida Atlantic. And, of course, Tom Herman, the new head coach there. This team went 5-7 last year. This was one of the most underproducing teams as far as losses is concerned, just regular wins and losses that I can remember seeing. They were 5-7, and their postgame win expectancy was 7.02 and 4.98. So 7-5 is what they were expected with the postgame win expectancy, and they did not get there. Didn't get there. This schedule this year is awesome for them, by the way. I kind of hate that Willie Taggart didn't get a chance here, but my gosh, you see, he just found ways to lose games consistently. It was frustrating, I'm sure, for Owl fans down there in Boca Raton. All right, so looking at returning production, number 18 in the country in adjusted returning production. You look at the roster strength here, and this is a Conference USA team that is coming into the AAC, and they are number 4 in the conference in roster strength, number 5 on offense, number 6 on defense. This team is pretty good, right? Like, they are kind of built. Number 1 in the country in defensive returning production. Of course, you see all that red and orange on the screen. They were number 98 in PPA per drive on defense. They were number 81 in rushing success allowed, number 116 in passing success. So, not great, but they do have a lot of experience. And they are bringing in, of course, a new coaching staff. So, that's going to be interesting. Starting on offense, Charlie Fry, he was the OC at Central Michigan back in 2019 and 2020. And then he went to join the Miami Dolphins as their quarterback's coach after that. The quarterback, Casey Thompson, transfers in from Nebraska. He should be an upgrade over Nikosi Perry. Even though the PPA numbers were really good on that offense last year, Casey Thompson, I would think, should be a little bit better. Running back Larry McCammon is back. Along with the offensive line, they returned 62% of the snaps. Talent is top half of the league. I just brought that up. So the issue is, can Charlie Fry get the new, can he get things clicking? Can he get some of the new guys clicking with some of those vets? Over onto the defense. Rock Bellantoni, well-traveled defensive coordinator. He was most recently the edge coach at Auburn. 18 of the top 21 tacklers are back for FAU. It's the most returning defensive experience in the country, but they weren't good last year. So is this progression, or is this you're just bringing in the same garbage that you had? We'll see. Maybe with a new coach, they could be better, and it's at least guys that have been there before. They're expected to start 2 transfers. You got Ambush at linebacker, Morris at cornerback, but defensive roster is number 6 in the conference, so obviously we'll see. They had very little luck last season. They were number 20 in turnover margin, number 67 in penalties per game. As far as injuries and the other team making unexpected field goals, etc., they were number 117 in the luck rank in the country, which you can see. They went 5-7. They were expected to go 7-5 based on all the stats of the season. So the keys to the season here. They are projected favorites in 7 games. Their win total sits at 7.5 at plus 850 to win the conference. They are minus 105 to go over, minus 125 to go under. Keys to the season. My question was, how did this team lose to Purdue and Western Kentucky last year? They should have made a bowl game. They need to stay healthy this year. Depth is a little bit of a concern at a majority of the positions, but the starters are really talented. Tom Herman, I think he is an upgrade over Willie Taggart. He knows how to coach. He seems to be growing a culture there. This looks like a fun place to go play right now. The schedule is awesome, right? Absolutely awesome. Weeks, 3 and 4, that's going to be difficult because you go to Clemson, you go to Illinois back-to-back. Yeah, that's going to be tough. But then you get a bye week in week 5 before you start AAC play. Yeah, conference road games couldn't be better this year. They've got at South Florida, at Charlotte, at UAB, at Rice. And then at home, you get Tulane at home, you get East Carolina at home, you get UTSA at home, and you get Tulsa at home. This schedule set up brilliantly. So I've got them going 8-4. I think the ceiling for this team could really be 10-2. But the floor, however, could not make a bowl game again. I think that's a legitimate concern because some of these games that I've got as wins, you could easily lose those along with the other ones. So 5-7 is the floor here. I like FAU this season. I like them. I think Tom Herman is going to do big things there. And then we'll see how long he stays. We shall see. Thanks for listening to Winning Cures Everything. Make sure and follow me on Twitter, at GaryWCE. If you want to toss in a question, you can email me, Gary@winningcureseverything.com. Make sure and hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next time.